Nerds. Hi, Yogis. Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. Today we are doing a flow inspired by the awesome Tomb Raider, Miss Lara Croft. Absolutely love Tomb Raider, games, the movies, everything. Really excited for the new movie. Can't wait to see it. One of the things that is amazing about Tomb Raider is her upper body strength. She's always pulling herself up over all this crazy stuff and rope swings and all kinds of superhuman strength. So won't quite get superhuman strength today, but we are going to work on upper body strength. And obviously don't have a pull-up bar here in the yoga studio, but we'll add some moves that do help with doing pull-ups. If you ever want to try a pull-up workout, some of these moves should help with that. Also, have a yoga block handy if you've got one. You could use a really sturdy book or something as well. We'll be using that later on in our cool down sequence. But to start, we're going to come into ankle to knee pose for our warm up. So right ankle just rests on top of left knee, so ankles and knees are in line. Don't have to worry about pushing the ankle down or anything like that. Just let gravity do its thing. We're not going to go into a deep stretch here, just letting the legs sit where they are, warming them up as we warm up our breath. So inhale up and exhale, twist to the right. Inhale up, exhale, twist to the left, and inhale up, twist to the right, hold it here a moment, one breath, inhaling deep to the low belly, exhale, squeeze everything in and out, and back to center, switch legs, or I guess switch which leg is on top, so left ankle comes on top, inhale here. Exhale, opening to the left, inhale up, exhale to the right, inhale up, exhale last time to the left, holding it here, inhale, exhale, one last one here, big inhale, deep to the low belly, exhale, squeeze everything in and out, exhaling through the nose, big Ujjayi victorious breath, inhale here, exhale. Awesome job. We'll make our way to our hands and knees, really grounding into the earth with our fingertips planting, the fingers planting the palms, light on the heel of the hands. Start with bent knees and elbows and then make your way up to downward facing dog. All right, now from here, pedal out your feet a little bit. You can bend the knees. Pedal out the feet, and I like to start the little bend in the knees, wave the spine long, get some traction in the neck, and then let the heels make their way down to the earth, wherever they will rest. You don't have to worry again about pressing down into the earth. We're not really warmed up yet, so don't want to strain ourselves. And from here, we're going to bend everything, get close to the earth, waving yourself into plank. Nice long plank here. And from here, we're going to do a variation of a body weight workout called Renegade Rows. So we'll do more of a yoga renegade plank. So in your high plank, you can also do this on knees. As a modification, we're just going to lift one arm and lift the other. And we'll do just a set of 10. That's only 5 on each. And just lifting, really want to use your back muscles engaging as well. Really getting into the core, of course. And try not to swing back and forth. You want to stay pretty level. A little movement is normal, obviously, as you're shifting weight, but. All right, that's the last one. So now do come onto your knees, wherever you are in your strength practice. We want good shoulder health as we're going to do some chaturanga push-ups, so lowering towards the earth and exhale, pressing back up. Inhale down, exhale up. You can lift your feet up if you want or keep them on the ground. One last one here. And now lowering all the way to the earth, planting the hips first. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, roll yourself in and up. And coming through pointed plank, or You can stay on your knees if you want. Make your way back to down dog. Awesome. Now we're gonna mix things up a little bit. I'm gonna start with my left leg first so you can see the move. But bending everything close to the earth. Inhale, lift the left leg high. It's fun to mix stuff up too, and every once in a while anyway. And from here, start by opening up the hips and just let that foot fall behind you. Starting to open up the hip flexor and your psoas. And exhale, keep that knee bent. Bring it up into the chest and step the left foot to your left thumb. Inhale here, prepare. We're gonna exhale, bending the back knee, rolling yourself in and up to high lunge. Awesome, now from here, you wanna align the hips, wave the spine tall, arms can unfurl to the sky, and then stretch out the back leg now that we have good alignment. And from here, we'll do some fierce lunges. So we're gonna inhale everything up. Exhale, coming into a lunge. As we exhale, press to the sides, pressing out through the palms. Inhale up. Exhale, fierce lunge. Inhale, one more time. Exhale. Now we'll do some fists of fire lunges all the way to the floor. So inhale everything up. And exhale, fists come to low belly. And tap the back knee to the floor. You can step a little closer too if the stance is a little too wide. First, good alignment. And exhale. Inhale last time, exhale, perfect. Inhale back to high lunge. From here, you're gonna plant your right hand underneath your right shoulder, and left arm is gonna come to the sky. So far, the left knee is still bent. Do some arm circles, so start by bending everything close to the earth, bending the arm, and then opening back up to sky, straightening that left leg to your first moment of stretch. Circling down, get rid of shoulder tension as we do this. One last time, circle down and arm comes to the sky. From here, you can hold it here, or if you are feeling it, rotate the palm behind you and do a half bind here. Stretching the legs that we worked. And from here, depending on how the stretch is feeling, you can keep your heel lifted, or if you want to get into the ankle stretch a bit more, you can come down a little closer to the earth. Just keeping a long spine. And exhale, everything comes back. We're going to make our way into down dog. We'll do another vinyasa flow like we started with, so bending everything, waving yourself forward to plank. We'll do our renegade plank here, so lifting one arm. And you can also widen your feet stance to get a little more stability. Just a couple more on each side. Last one. Awesome. Coming onto your knees, lowering towards the earth. And exhale, press yourself back up. Lower down. Come back up. Last time here, lower and up. Awesome, and of course, lowering all the way to the earth this time is inhale, prepare, and waving in and up to cobra and back to down dog. Pedaling out the feet again. It's a kind of a massage for the arches of your feet and helps open up the calf muscles. And we, of course, have two sides, so we'll try that on the other. So bending everything close to the earth. Inhale the right leg high, starting by opening the hips and dropping the right foot behind you. Excellent, and right knee comes to the chest, lifting high in core plank, and then stepping the right foot to your right thumb. Inhale here, prepare a long spine, bending the back knee, getting our solid foundation and good alignment as we roll ourselves in and up. A high lunge. Then from here, we'll do our fierce lunges. So inhale up, exhale, pressing out through the palms. Inhale up, and really think about pressing away. I mean, the air, but anything, of course, that doesn't serve you as well. That'll strengthen the arms. And inhale up, exhale, this time fists of fire lunges. Left knee taps the ground. Inhale up, exhale. Last time here, inhale up and exhale. Back to our high lunge. And we'll do our reverse triangle stretch. So coming onto our left hand underneath our left shoulder, right arm unfurls to the sky. And circling everything, get close to the earth and opening it back up. Exhale. Finding that first edge of stretch in your right leg. Last time, hold it here. Again, you can stay in this position or start by rotating the palm behind you and then going into the half bind. That rotation is going to help you keep a healthy shoulder while doing this arm pose. And of course, you can stay high on the back toes or lowering and stretching the heel more. Remembering to use your Mula Bandha breath. One more inhale, exhale, and make your way back to plank to down dog. We'll do one more vinyasa. So bending everything close to the earth, waving yourself forward to your high plank. Again, you can widen your stance for the renegade plank. So lifting one arm, really noticing how engaged your core is, how much you're using your arms, how much you're using your back. All right, one more round on each side, bonus round. Awesome. Knees come to the floor, our last set of chaturanga push-ups, so lowering down, coming back up, lower down, back up, one last one. And now here, lower all the way to the earth, hips plant first, inhale here, prepare, waving yourself up to cobra. If you're feeling warm enough, up dog, just lift the legs off the floor and back to your down dog. Awesome, now take a big inhale here. Exhale, stick out the tongue, lion's breath. Let's do one more of those for good measure. Inhale, exhale. Your tongue is actually the top of the deep core line, so we're still working our core when we'll do that. We're doing that. Awesome, from here, making your way onto hands and knees. Come to sit for just a moment. We're going to flip ourselves over. So however you need to get there, coming into this seated position. Feet are going to plant on the floor. Fingertips are going to plant behind you. We'll start by pressing up into a tabletop position. Do a fun move called Tibetan swing. So from here, you are going to swing your hips back behind you, really pressing up through the hands. Inhale here. Exhale. Inhale up. We're only going to do a couple of them. Exhale. Really making sure that you're bending your arms between this. It'll help create space for you to move your hips. And it's okay if you stop here, if you need to start with bent knees and slide through. Really just find whatever works for you as you build up the strength in these poses. And last one. Awesome scene. If you can press, lift, hold, 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 and come down. Woo, feels good. All right, take a moment of rest. Right ankle comes on top of left knee again. I'm gonna inhale, breath of freedom here. Exhale, give yourself a nice big hug. Inhale, exhale. It's like cat-cow, but you're giving yourself some loving. And come to sit, you can shake out your wrists, massage your forearms, roll out the wrists. Good. We've been doing obviously a lot of wrist work, so it's good to show them some love as well. And our last move is gonna be upward plank. This is again another good one for the pull-up motion. If you ever wanna get a pull-up bar or a go to a monkey bars or something and try it out. So from here, feet are gonna be stretched out long in front of you, planting your fingertips, again, gripping into the earth, planting the palms of your hands, still light on the heel. And start, of course, as always, with bent elbows. Get that momentum, get that physics. And then, also, wave the spine long, engage the core, and lift up into upward plank. This is a fun pose. It's also a good counter pose for all of the kind of push-ups and chaturanga things that we did. Stretching and pressing the muscles the other direction. Just seeing if you can hold it for a couple more breaths. And one more bonus breath, and then relax, bring it down to the earth. Coming back to our ankle to knee. This time, left ankle on top. Inhale, exhale, breath of freedom. Light traverse, which arm is on top as well. And shake out the wrists again. Massage your forearms. Now, doing the magic wrist clear. You really want to get traction between the wrists, so gripping here at the bones and really try to pull your wrist away from your arm. That'll create some traction there, help open up the wrist from all the work that we did. Awesome. Now we're going to come into a kind of roly-poly position. We did have a request for some plow and shoulder stand, but we're going to do it with a Nerdy Yogi twist. So coming into a tight roly-poly position, we will do some rock and roll. So massage basically for the spine, so it feels really nice. It's a good way to test your balance when you're on your sits bones here and still uses the core a little. Now this last time, if it feels okay to you, you can bring your knees overhead and grab your hands onto your lower back. You don't want to ever do plow without supporting yourself. So from here, you can keep your knees up above you. You can stretch them out long behind you. Some people like to bend their knees around their head. I sometimes will alternate which leg is straight, but just find a comfortable position in plow. Again, supporting, using your hands to support your low back. And still, and press your head into the ground and keep that space open for your neck. You don't want to crush your cervical spine here, because that obviously is no good. You can play with flexing your feet, pointing your feet, find what stretch you need. You can open the legs. Take a yogi's choice moment to dance here safely in plow. And then roll yourself slowly and supported back to the earth. Now from here, this is where I want you to grab your block. Now I typically don't practice normal shoulder stand in my yoga practice because, again, it's quite easy to hurt your neck. And you get all of the same benefits doing a supported shoulder stand as you do non-supported. And I think this is way more relaxing and comfortable, so why would I not do this one? So take the block, plant your feet into the earth, lift your hips, and plant the block right under your hips. You don't want it in your low back. You don't want it too low on your buttocks. But a comfortable position on the hips, right around the sacrum. So get cozy. If you find that it's pinching or hurting, move the block around. And from here, start by walking your feet out wide and letting the knees just fall towards each other. Arms can open in whatever rest position you can. Rest them above your head. That feels nice sometimes. Open. And you can always hit pause, of course, on the video if you want to take any of these variations a little longer, but we'll walk our feet back together. You might need to adjust the block a little if it moved. And then gently bring your knees up. Again, adjust the block as needed to find a comfortable position. Now from here, you can keep your knees bent or lift your feet to the sky in your supported shoulder stand. And the trick is here, you want to see if you can do this with as little energy as possible. Obviously, it's hard because you're having to hold your legs up in the air, but see if you can not make it like a so much work. See if you can just kind of let them float there. Like they feel like they're being held up maybe by a string, or maybe the air is so dense it's holding them up for you. And that way you're not feeling like you're fighting gravity. You're letting your legs kind of just float above you. Ooh, maybe like zero gravity. Like I said, you get all of the same detox benefits as you do from shoulder stand, the lymphatic system working. So it's great to be in a position like this. You can even go up against a wall and put your feet up against the wall. That's really good to do. Like I said, feel free to hit pause if you want to hold any of these variations for longer than we're doing today. But feel free to slowly make your way out of that pose, planting the feet onto the earth, lifting your hips off the block, moving that out of the way, walking yourself down into Shavasana. You can windshield wiper the legs a moment. That always feels nice. And take any Yogi's Choice stretches that you might need. And then we'll do some typical arm stretches here in Shavasana. You don't always have to be sitting or standing to do these. You can do them lying down. But stretch your right arm across your chest. Obviously, we did a lot of arm work. Switch arms. And then bring your right arm above your head. You can hook onto your elbow. And you can even do a side bend. Get into the traps a bit. Some people do the whole pulling it behind their head. You can do that. We're just going for a gentle stretch before we go into our final resting pose. Then switch sides. I like to moonwalk over to one side a bit. Get into that side body. And then making your way in your Shavasana, your final resting pose. Staying here for a couple of minutes before going into the rest of your day, taking all of this Tomb Raider strength with you. And remember that you can climb over any obstacle that is in your way. If she can do some of the stuff that she can do in that game, you can do anything. Honestly, some of it's totally crazy. All right, yogis. I hope you enjoyed this practice. Please share it with anyone that you think might enjoy it with you. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Make sure that you get updates for when all the new videos come out. And of course, get on the League of Nerdy Yogis email list. We've got exclusive content there just for you. So look forward to seeing you there. Namaste.